How can you fall or jump from space on different solar system planets? Have you ever seen a fruit or object fall from a tree? Have you ever tried to throw a stone by observing how it falls to the ground? This force that pushes things down is called the force of gravity. We're constantly drawn towards the Earth by its gravitational force. That is why we always stay with our feet on the ground. In essence, gravity depends on mass. All objects from stars, planets, and galaxies to light and subatomic particles are attracted to each other. Depending on the size, mass, and density of the object, the gravitational force it exerts varies. And when it comes to the planets in our solar system, which vary in size and mass, the gravitational force on their surfaces varies greatly. The gravity exerted between two objects is directly proportional to the product of their mass and inversely proportional to the square of their mutual distance. In short, the more massive two bodies are, the more they attract each other, but this force diminishes very rapidly from the moment they begin to move away from each other. And moving away from the center of our planet is precisely what we try to do with spacecraft. To get out of Earth's gravitational hull, we must reach and exceed the so-called escape velocity, which is about 11.2 kilometers per second. At this speed, we could move from London to New York in just 10 minutes. When a shuttle reaches this speed, it can escape Earth's gravitational field and travel freely in the solar system. Gravity is a fundamental force of physics, one which we Earthlings tend to take for granted. You can't really blame us, having evolved throughout millions of years in Earth's environment. So it's not easy to imagine what it would be like to move, walk, to run on other planets, where the acceleration of gravity might be very different from that of our planet of origin. In this video, we are about to give you a complete review of the strange situations you might encounter. Based on their sizes and masses, the gravity on another planet is often expressed in terms of G units, as well as in terms of the rate of freefall acceleration, i.e. in meters per second. Earth's gravity is equivalent to 9.8 meters per second. This means that an object, if held above the ground and let go, will accelerate towards the surface at a speed of about 9.8 meters for every second of freefall. This is the standard for measuring gravity on other planets, which is also expressed as a single G. Basically, it works like this. Near the Earth's surface, an object falls with an acceleration that causes it to fall 4.9 meters after 1 second, nearly 25 meters after 2 seconds, nearly 45 meters after 3 seconds, and so on. And there is a very simple formula for calculating this. Space equals half G times squared. Try doing the calculations yourself. If we then wanted to know the time it takes for an object to reach the ground from a height, let's say 100 meters, we would just transform the formula like this. Time equals 100 divided by half g to the power of 0.5. And in this case, the result will be 4.5 seconds. But if we wanted to calculate the speed with which the same object impacts the Earth's ground, well, we would simply apply the formula. Speed equals g time. To get a result of 44 meters per second or 159 kilometers per hour. Okay, this whole discussion might be quite boring, but it will certainly be useful for you to understand and verify what we are about to discover. Now let's leave the formulas alone and go on to put what we have just said into practice, trying to visualize what very normal terrestrial physical activities would look like on other planets. Like a soccer game, for example. Let's try to consider two classic phases of the game. The aerial takeoff of the soccer player who under the goal tries to hit the ball with his head, and the waiting time for the return to the ground of a ball hurled up to a certain height. Normally, a gifted soccer player on Earth can get off the ground, jumping with feet together, by at least half a meter. But how would this go on all the other objects in the solar system? How far would he be able to jump? A ball thrown 30 meters high here on Earth returns to the ground after just 2.5 seconds. But on Mars? On Jupiter? On Phobos? Let's try to find out by reviewing all the classic planets of the solar system, plus a few objects with more extreme characteristics. Gravity on Mercury. With a mean diameter of about 4,888 kilometers, Mercury is approximately one-third the size of Earth, and about 18 times less massive than Earth. This makes Mercury the smallest and least massive planet in the solar system. However, thanks to its high density, a robust 5.43 grams per cubic centimeter, which is just slightly lower than Earth's 5.5 grams per cubic centimeter, Mercury has a surface gravity of 3.7 meters per second squared, which is the equivalent of 0.38 g. Okay, if we played soccer on Mercury, a soccer player jumping to hit the ball head-on would be 1.3 meters off the surface, while players on the field would have to wait 4 seconds for the ball to become playable again after a 30-meter flight. Gravity on Venus. Venus is similar to Earth in many ways, which is why it is often referred to as Earth's twin. With a diameter of 12,200 kilometers, a mass that is 0.815 times that of Earth's, and roughly 0.95 times as dense, it's no surprise why the gravity on Venus is very close to that of Earth's 0.9 g, or 8.9 meters per second squared. Thus, we should also not be surprised that a soccer game on Venus would be played under almost the same conditions as on Earth. A soccer player would jump 0.6 meters and the ball would take 2.6 seconds to return to the ground. Gravity on the Moon. This is an astronomical body where humans have experienced firsthand the effects of decreased gravity. Based on the average diameter of 3,474 kilometers, mass 81 times smaller than Earth's, and density of 3.3 g's per cubic centimeter, the Moon's surface gravity has been measured to be 1.62 meters per second squared, or 0.165 g. Applying the formulas we discussed earlier, from this data we get that a soccer player would be able to jump onto the Moon to a height of 2.7 meters, and the players on the field would have to wait 6 seconds before the ball would descend again from a height of 30 meters. Gravity on Mars. Mars is also similar to Earth in many key respects. However, when it comes to size, mass, and density, Mars is comparatively small. In fact, its mean diameter of 6,678 kilometers is the equivalent of roughly 0.53 Earths, while its mass is just 0.107 Earths. Its density comes in at a relatively modest 3.9 g per centimeter cubed. Because of this, Mars has 0.38 times the gravity of Earth, which works out to be 3.7 meters per second squared. It might be surprising to see that despite Mars being twice as massive as Mercury, gravitational pull at the surface of the two planets is actually the same, 0.38 g. This indicates that Mercury is much denser than Mars, and therefore its surface is closer to its center of mass than Mars is. And as we saw earlier, gravity is stronger when the distance between two masses is smaller. As for the soccer game, a player on Mars would therefore jump the same size jumped on Mercury, or 1.3 meters, and the ball would also take the same time of 4 seconds to descend to the ground. Gravity on Jupiter. Jupiter is the largest and most massive planet in the solar system. Its mean diameter at 140,000 kilometers makes it 11 times the size of Earth, while its mass is the equivalent of 318 Earths. But being a gas giant, Jupiter is naturally less dense than Earth and other terrestrial planets, with a mean density of 1.33 g per centimeter cubed. What's more, being a gas giant, Jupiter does not have a true surface. If one were to stand on it, they would simply sink until they eventually arrived at its theorized solid core. As a result, Jupiter's surface gravity, which is defined as the force of gravity at its cloud tops, is 24.8 meters per second squared, or 2.5 g. Imagine playing a game on a space platform. A soccer player would barely be able to get 0.2 meters off the ground, and the ball would only take 1.5 seconds to descend from a height of 30 meters. Even in the case of Jupiter, the low density and thus the distance of the surface from the planet's center of mass greatly scales down the effects of a mass that would suggest a much stronger gravity. Gravity on Saturn. Like Jupiter, Saturn is a huge gas giant that is significantly larger and more massive than Earth, but far less dense. In short, its mean radius is 116,500 kilometers. Its mass is 95 times as massive, and has a density of 0.7 g per centimeter cubed. As a result, its surface gravity, again measured from the top of its clouds, is just slightly more than Earth's, 10.4 meters per second squared, or 1.07 g. One would think that such a large and massive planet should have a very high gravity at the surface. But for the reasons already stated, the hypothetical soccer game played at the top of its clouds would be played almost as well as on Earth. A soccer player would come off to a height of 0.4 meters, and the ball would return to the ground in 2.4 seconds. Gravity on Uranus. With a mean diameter of 50,700 kilometers, Uranus is approximately 4 times the size of Earth, and 14.5 times as massive. However, as a gas giant, its density, 1.27 g per centimeter cubed, is significantly lower than Earth's, hence why its surface gravity, measured from its cloud tops, is slightly weaker than Earth's, 8.7 meters per second squared, or 0.9 g. Again, despite its size, there is not much difference with Earth's gravity. A soccer player would be able to jump 0.6 meters and the ball would fall back to the ground in just over 2 seconds. Gravity on Neptune. With a mean radius of 49,000 kilometers, Neptune is the fourth largest planet in the solar system. All told, it's 4 times the size of Earth and 17 times as massive. But being a gas giant, it has a low density of 1.6 g per centimeter cubed. All of this works out to a surface gravity of 11 meters per second squared, or 1.14 g, which again is measured at Neptune's cloud tops. In short, on the last planet in the solar system, a soccer game would turn out to be quite smooth, with players coming off the ground by 0.4 meters and balls taking 2.3 seconds to descend from a height of 30 meters. Gravity on Ceres. The dwarf planet, king of the asteroid belt, has an average diameter of 940 kilometers and a mass that is only 6/1000ths of Earth. Its surface gravity is just 0.27 meters per second squared, which would allow a football to come off the ground to a height of as much as 16 meters. In contrast, the ball falling from a height of 30 meters would take 15 seconds to descend again. Imagine how a game might unfold, where players kick the ball and then stand with their noses up to wait for its return. Gravity on Phobos. The larger of the two Martian moons is nevertheless very small. In fact, it possesses an average diameter of only 22.5 kilometers and a virtually insignificant mass. Its surface gravity, as a result, averages just 0.0057 meters per second squared, so that a soccer player could rise by jumping feet first to a height of 88 meters, and the return of the ball to the ground would have to wait for 102 seconds, almost 2 minutes. With the danger then of dozens of balls being lost in space during the game, the escape velocity from Phobos being only 41 kilometers per hour, a speed that a soccer ball tossed from one side of the field to the other could easily overcome. And on the Sun? We almost forgot about the host. The Sun has a huge diameter of almost 1.4 million kilometers and a mass that is 333,000 times that of the Earth. The density is not much, but still the force of gravity measured on the photosphere is 274 meters per second squared. Playing a game on our star would mean having players jumping less than a couple of inches and balls coming back down in as little as 0.5 seconds. All in all, gravity runs the gamut here in the solar system, ranging from 0.38 g on Mercury and Mars to a powerful 2.53 g atop Jupiter's clouds. And on the Moon, where astronauts have ventured, it is a very mild 0.165 g, which allowed for some fun experiments in near weightlessness. Understanding the effect of zero gravity on the human body has been essential to space travel, especially where long-duration missions in orbit and to the International Space Station have been concerned. In the coming decades, knowing how to simulate it will come in handy when we start sending astronauts on deep space missions. And of course, knowing just how strong it is on other planets will be essential to manned missions and perhaps even settlement there. Given that humanity evolved in a 1G environment, knowing how we will fare on planets that have only a fraction of the gravity could mean the difference between life and death.